You can sit here. Yeah. Come on down.
I'm just going to take some photos.
Okay.
Use the word Burmese.
Yeah. So that's like our slogan.
Nice.
What's that? Is that a live stream or that here, or is that just a CCTV?
Hey, it's finally the time now for the live conversations with my brother from a different mother. And right, so I hope that you guys are ready. So without further ado, we are finally live on MI Radio, and this is a shout out from my brother. Hello.
Hi, Russell. Thanks for calling me here.
Yeah, thanks for being here, and we do appreciate that. And I'm sure that you are a busy man. You have, you know, so many things going on, but still, you take your time to spend your Friday evening, you know, with that. So I really do appreciate that. Well, with that being said, we're gonna talk, you know, a lot of crazy stuff. You know, yeah, we're gonna, you know, get down. We're gonna get
looking
down.
All right, do a show in English in Burma.
All right, you can. Oh, okay. So, guys, if you were wondering, you know, I mean, our guests today don't really need any introductions, but well, let me do that honor by doing that. So, well, our Mikis, it's also a really, really talented hip hop artist, and also he can speak really well in Myanmar. So, yes. Well, before we start, you know, getting into our topics and our fun stuff, so let's start off with introducing yourself.
Well, I'm Mikis from Germany, and I currently live in Myanmar since about 2 years, where I do music. I started off with a complete different plan, honestly. When I came here first, I never thought that I would turn out this way, but apparently destiny always provides a path, so now we're here, and I'm glad it went that way, and
So, what's your first impressions of, you know, Myanmar? Like, the first day you got here, like, what hit you?
Honestly, I was pretty preordained when I came here, because I know Myanmar since I was a kid, as my father always came here, and he
took me
to the Myanmar border when I was 12, I think, for the first time. So I always was interested to come to Southeast Asia, and then when I finished school, I finally made the choice for myself to actually move to Southeast Asia for a year to check it out, see how I like it, and fell in love with the people, fell in love with the country, learned the language, and apparently that opened a lot of doors, and here I am now. So.
Right, so yeah, because I can... well, I can really imagine, because the weather is totally different. You know, in Germany, it's a lot colder than, you know, than Southeast Asia in general, right?
It's
so
true. Like,
how do you adjust that?
I mean, I'm used to, like, Yangon, for instance, is a pretty rainy city, so I'm used to rain from my city of Bremen and Hamburg already, but it's warm, it's hot, it's humid, and of course I have to get used to it, so, but... I don't know, it's like in Germany it's really, really cold, and here it's really, really hot, so whether really cold or really hot, like, which one do you prefer? Of course I prefer really hot, so I'd rather stay here.
Guys, as we speak, we got some phenomenon, so I hope that you guys bear with that, but you know, it's not even cool, because look at the monitor, you know, it's like really cool lighting we have in the studio.
Pretty
so
romantic, actually.
And also in the studio we have another, you know, special friend of yours, that is Marcel. Hello, Marcel. Well, yeah, it's kind of delayed, but still, it's awesome. So, yeah, and well, we're gonna talk more about that after, you know. Also, we chosen some songs that you might, you know, probably like, because, you know, we asked some songs that inspire you musically. So, well, I know that, you know, you have a lot of musical influences from hip hop in general. So, what? Why hip hop, and which song, like, or artists in particular, like, started your, you know, passion with hip hop?
Well, I think I was born in early 1992, so there was like just the time when hip hop really evolved, and hip hop became a world culture. And for me, I'm pretty lucky that I made this, like, I was born in this very in this unique time for hip hop. So for me, when I was a kid already, I used to get influenced by my parents' music, which was hip hop as well, because my parents listened to hip hop even, and for me, I was for me, I like poetry, I like reading, so for me, hip-hop is something that, besides the music, it also delivers some kind of feeling through the lyrics, and for me, hip-hop has to deliver a message, and
exactly.
That's why, like, honestly, for me, I'm not that much into the new hip-hop anymore,
right?
Especially, like, trap or whatever, like, not that much. Of course, there are a few good songs too, but like, for me, it has to have a message, and that's for me,
right? Like,
you
a
have
two
to make
pie.
A difference, true. So you have to make a difference between rap and hip-hop, and for me, rap music is something that's it's a message and speaks to your heart. So for me,
exactly,
KRS-One and Guru, I don't know, they're not that big in Asia, I think, but in Germany and America, like, they're one of the pioneers. So for me, they were the first one to make me love this kind of music, and
right, yeah, really, really cool to hear that. And also, we're gonna have a conversation about what's your current activity after we play the next songs, which is Running by the First Sight. Is it
Farsight? It's the Farsight. Farsight is another big big influence. Farsight is a huge crew. You're gonna love it, and hope you all enjoy that.
Okay, so well, we're gonna hit off the first song. This is Running, the Farsight, and where are they from?
The Farsight is they're from the USA. So it's a group. They're all from I think they're from New York, actually, but I'm not sure if all of them are from New York. But
right.
Yeah,
okay.
That's true hip hop. For me, this is real hip hop. No mishuibu.
Okay, no sugar coating.
No sugar coating. It's like
it's
like real music from the heart, you know? It's no gangster stuff, mm-hmm. And no, like, it's good music.
Alright, so with that being said, we're gonna start with Running, the First Sight. Please enjoy. Okay, we just have a cut. Anyway, so we're gonna be also live. When we were playing music, and what we're gonna do is when we're going live, we won't be playing music too loud, because the Facebook can really like delete, they can do that, done instances in the past that they we're like doing live for an hour, and then
they cut out your music.
No, they cut off, we can't upload the video. The whole video got cut off.
Damn.
Yeah, so
rights for the songs, yeah, okay.
Right.
So yeah.
I share some can you share that on your
I just wanted to say I think I'm gonna do something now. I think maybe do even a live.
Yeah, we can do a live.
So wait, it's with
my followers.
It's a little foggy, no? So you might wanna like,
is it?
Oh yeah.
I think it's that foggy. I wanna have the logo up here, like.
Nice. All right. So this is what I do. Where it work? Oh, right. So we got. I think if you can also share the MI radio.
That's nice.
Right.
I love how this guy just looked at me, the what's his name?
Kenneth.
Because I said, like, to Burma, and I said...
Oh, yeah. He's like...
Yeah.
So, you can listen to us 96.1 and
yeah.
Also 96.5.
Yeah, I already posted it.
96.7, yeah. Hello, Miglaba. Just if you have any hip hop songs that's really cool, then hook me up,
Like for the radio show in general?
Just
or for
me.
For yourself.
Yeah, for myself.
That's actually one of my favorite hobbies, is sharing good music with good
right.
friends. You know, like to
it's like sharing a good movie, you know, like watch it, you know, it's,
there's honestly like, no, we're not laughing, so there's so much shit
we are
on, no, but like not
we are, you know? We're live on my radio.
There's so much shit on the world that is that we yeah, like we have so much bad music around, like especially
exactly.
in the charts, like because like we have an overload of music, you know,
exactly.
Like nowadays everybody can mm-hmm. make music.
Exactly.
So nowadays everybody who has a computer basically can sit down and make a song.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that, like, so the pearls and the diamonds of
yeah.
music, you know, like they're still, they're hidden somewhere, so you have to be introduced to them or find them on it by accident.
Too, but like
you have a very good radio voice, by the way. We just thought downstairs, like you have such a.
Like, so the pearls and the diamonds of
yeah.
music, you know, like they're still, so you have to be
okay.
to
yeah.
find them on it by accident. Too, but like
okay.
3, 2, 1,
So most of the voices are from here.
To the world, this is MI Radio, the newest, most exciting chapter in the history of broadcasting in Myanmar. Here's what people are saying about MI Radio.
제가 좋아하는 한국 드라마의 노래를 들었습니다. 그것은 굉장합니다.
I love how you.
My radio, my way.
Hey, back at it again with, you know, DJ Russells and my bro Mikis back in the house, back in the studio. Yeah, so I am really, really excited. And first of all, let me just thank you for just being here. You are amazing.
Thank
and
you.
Well, I know that you know you have a really busy schedule, so that, I mean, it means a lot to not just me, the whole radio station. So well, I'm not sure you will know it, like we are your fans, basically. So
I appreciate that.
So
you too.
Yeah, Mikis here, Fendi, ba. Okay. So, well, what are your current activities? I mean, okay, let's start with the past. So, what's the first gig that, you know, first job that you had, you know, when you arrived in Myanmar? Myanmar bi yao dong, bada ma uzo.
Well, honestly, I'm gonna speak in English now. First,
yeah, of course.
So it's like when I came here first, like the very first time to Myanmar, it was I was actually not even in Myanmar. I was at the border between Myanmar and Thailand, and that's where I fell in love with the Myanmar culture and the Myanmar
wow.
people. So I was in Myawadi and Mesaw, and
oh yeah,
time, no? And then this
I love
time,
that.
I was basically working the regular stuff that a foreigner would work in this area, doing NGO work, and then I came back to Germany, figuring out for myself what I want to do, and I had to go to Myanmar. That was like a main
right.
goal for me. So. For that, I had to have a business visa, and for that, I would have to have a job. So,
right.
So I was thinking for myself, okay, I learned Myanmar language,
uh-huh.
and for me, it's like it was definitely a door opener. So that made it happen. That made it possible for me to work at the Goethe Institute, which is the German Culture Institute internationally,
right.
and had a great job there. But somehow things got out of hand. Like
mm.
I was working. I always used to do music since I was a kid, basically. So doing music in Myanmar, in like partially in Myanmar language,
right?
With the right context. So before I came here, I already had context to some actors here in the national acting scene and whatever, like Nedo and then whatever, like those.
Oh,
kind, those kind
so
of people.
You were familiar.
So those kind of people introduced me to other people and
network,
you know,
of people.
Networks, and that's
got
how
you
things
here.
Go. And then I had my first gig, and suddenly there was like a little documentary that was made about me, and suddenly, without even noticing, I had like a couple of 100,000 fans on Facebook and whatnot.
Yeah, I mean,
and
you have like 210,000. I think even more
since
followers.
Since today, 220. But it's no, but for me, honestly, like honestly, for me, that's weird. Like, to be honest, it's for me, it's a bit strange, to be frank, because in Germany we don't like Facebook is in Myanmar. Facebook is
it's
huge.
A really
you know,
popular.
It's huge.
Huge.
It's a source of information. It's a source of communication. And for Myanmar, it's especially like everybody is basically using Facebook.
Yeah, everybody.
Right? So
everybody.
Kid, every elderly person. So. It's crazy how those things can explode within days.
Exactly.
And that made it happen. Like for me, of course, like a few things went viral, especially over Facebook, also over YouTube a bit, but that's not that much used in here. So suddenly it came to the point that I couldn't sit in my office peacefully, because like people actually went into my door and said like, oh, komiki, and like
signature,
so it was like, it was kind of a weird situation that I had to get used to. And then I was talking with my former boss, and he said like, yeah, maybe you should concentrate on your
career,
hobby, basically, because it was a hobby, you know.
Was
doing music, and then it came that we had like I had people asking me if I want to star in a movie, like in as the main actor in the movie, the lead, and those kind of things. And I never thought that this could happen.
That escalated really quickly. Well, let me just tell you, you know, it's not just about, because you are a tourist, you know, but because you have a really great personality. Guys, if you're listening to this, you know, Mikis, you know, it's one of the coolest and also like the realest people that I've ever met. And you have a really good personality, and also like, you don't like try to be somebody that you're not. And we can totally see you. That's probably the reason why people, you know, fall in love with you, you know, or respect you in a way. So that's why, you know, that's what I can tell. You know, I have a really, you know, I never, well, when I first met you, you were already like in your lane. You know, you were doing like movies and stuff, and I never thought that you would like, oh, you know, hi, I'm Mikis, and you came to me and you introduced me. So that was like, wow. He is something, you know.
That's what I think. Like, for me, I think like, however famous you are, even if you're Leonardo DiCaprio or whoever, like a world star, you know, I would. That's something I promised to myself. Like, you should never get this attitude, you know. Like, you should never like, I'm better than you because I'm more famous, or because I'm whatnot. I'm not like that. I will sit.
Right.
I said like to the first video that was ever released in Myanmar was a documentary where I was sitting in a tea shop, and I said like that I love the tea shop culture. I want to know everything about Myanmar culture, because I live here and I want to know about the culture, I want to know about the language and whatnot, and I will never stop sitting in a tea shop. So even if I get 2 million followers or 50 million, whatever,
you will. I mean, at this rate that you're going, you will. And of course, like, with that being said, I would love you to help our very friend Marcel as well with the followers.
I got my friend here from Germany.
You want to say
we
hi?
Actually met through
the camera is here, so you might probably want to
just move in.
He's a really good friend from Germany, and we actually met. It's a funny story through the love of Myanmar. Like, we both love Myanmar, and we have a mutual friend in Germany, and they. And she said to him like, hey, I have a friend who knows Myanmar, he was there before, and then she introduced each other, and now he's here, and he wants to move here.
Right, and, that is awesome. Okay, so hopefully, you know, after this, you know, live sessions, hopefully your followers goes up.
That's what I'm looking for right now.
That's basically the only purpose why he's here.
Okay, guys, so so we're going to talk more about your, you know, ongoing activities after we play the next songs, and also, yeah, we have so many great, you know, topics to discuss, so stay tuned for all of that. And right now I would love to play another song by Rut, because it, you know, it's got my name in it. And it's called What They Want.
What They Want.
What They Want. Alright, let's get right
into it.
Okay. Alright, that was smooth.
At least 10 more followers. getting to the 220,000, right?
I'm sure we'll have.
I remember when we were like checking your followers, and I was like, no, you got 100,000, and you were like, yeah, and then, no, you got 150,000. I was like, told him, like,
oh, wow. I never really paid attention until today, because I just saw there was,
I think, 220,000.
Yeah, but since
I think it's more than that. It's crazy. It's awesome.
Honestly, I don't think that your followers on Facebook say anything about your celebrity status,
course,
or whatever,
course.
Because like, it's. It's only Facebook, you know?
Right.
But
still, it works here in a way, because, you know, well, back in the days, you know, my parents were like, oh, why are you, like, fixated on Facebook? You know, they're not going to, like feed you. But now they can feed you.
Yeah, it does.
You know, like, mostly some of the commercials, comedies are looking for people with certain amount of, you know, followers. Okay, if you have... And also, every post you make, you know, depending on the followers you get, you know, the pace is different.
But honestly, if I would be a director and I would look out for a new talent for my movie, you know, I would look for a new actor, I wouldn't look like how many furloughs did
yeah, exactly.
she got. I would look for the appearance, talent. for the you know, for the talent, look at some references. But what I think Facebook is the best for is connecting, you know? So
right.
you can connect people that you could never connect before, and you could connect, like, you
right.
could be connected. So,
exactly.
like, I'd say, like, probably more than 50%, like, maybe 80% of all the mm-hmm. all the requests that I got for mm-hmm. for collaborations and what was all over Facebook.
Exactly.
So, thank you, Mark Zuckerberg, but...
well, this is from Min Aung-Pieso, and nice to meet you. He's saying that to you.
Where's the camera? Is that the camera?
Yeah, that's a camera. Shout out to me, Jizo. Yeah. Well, I mean, we are starting out. You know, we are starting out as a radio, and also, I mean, thanks for like honestly, thanks for being here. You know, I'm sure like we are on the path of something great. You know,
I hope like, so. But it's like in Burmese they say "ganga ijo nyanya ijo." You know, so like we
okay.
try to go.
Treat
everybody with respect and
yeah,
well,
the way you want to be treated,
and don't exploit.
Of course,
song's over.
All right. Yeah, that was a good one.
I love this one.
Okay, so back at it again. Well, this is DJ Russell's, and I am joined by this awesome brother, Mikis, and also another awesome brother, Marcells. Hi.
No. Marcell and Russell.
Yeah, Marcell and Russell.
Marcell and Russell, my brothers from another mother's.
Yes, we can make a team, you know. Yeah. We can make a harmonies team. All right. So, well, everybody knows you for the fact that you can speak really well in Myanmar language, so Myanmar. So, how did that come about? Who taught you? And but I heard some, you know, good news from your friends that you have really really cool gift when it comes to language. You can just pick it up really quick. Is
yeah,
that true?
Apparently, like, there's either or. Like, so for example, some people are really good with numbers, some others are good with languages. I'm
uh-huh.
the worst with numbers, like mathematics and physics. Like, as soon as I could deselect that in my school, I did that.
Mm.
But I love languages, and for me, apparently, it's quite easy to pick it up. But I said there's no recipe. Like, the number one thing you have to have it's like a passion. It's a passion and a motivation. So you
right.
have to. So you have to sit down and really like. You have to want it. You don't have to like just for a school or for like
mm-hmm.
Make your parents like you better or whatever. You know, like you have to.
Exactly.
You have to want it yourself and have. When I first moved to Mesot back in the days. It's Thailand, but still it's full of Myanmar people, especially like Karen people and like
right.
you know. So, for me, I made mostly Myanmar friends, and I wanted to be able to communicate with them. So,
what's the first line that you learned?
It's funny that because I actually remember it was "jet du yue." Was my first word I ever learned was "jet du yue."
Parrot,
and "mong la u." Mong la u and jet du yue. They were the first things I learned in Burmese.
Wow,
like
what
reddish and parrot. I have no idea. Don't ask me why I learned them.
That's the first word, you guys.
They're
so.
Literally the first words that are written down in the book that I wrote for myself. Like
oh, jet du yue, mong la u.
Jet du yue, mong la u.
Wow. And, well, so who helped you along with the language? Because, you know, I heard that because I'm a Myanmar guy, so I know from a fact that, you know, it's not easy learning this language.
For me, it's...
You've gone really far with the language, so...
It's, as I said, I had a motivation back in Mesa because I wanted to learn it for my friends. I wanted to... I didn't have... I had one foreigner friend back in Mesa. So
right.
I did this by choice. You know, he or Jeshi, so like, I didn't want to have... I wanted to learn about Myanmar culture, and I wanted to dive in, like, as much as I could. So for me, that was, like, the one motivation. And then I had a couple of friends that could speak English, but I told them, don't. Like, speak to me in Myanmar, and if I don't understand something, I will ask you
yeah,
again.
Yeah, of course.
But so I just sat down on my bottom, and I just, like, I tried, and I wrote
that
down... Every word, I always said tabale, tamiyama lobolo hale, alomi.
Oh, that's how you do it. How you do it, guys.
Yeah.
Okay, so I heard that. Well, Marcell, you can have your opinion in this. Well, people say that if you want to learn a language really well, you have to, you know, get a boyfriend or girlfriend who can speak the language, you know. Does it help? Do you agree with that? for sure.
I guess yes, sure.
I guess, okay, because like if you want to really learn Korean language, and then get a Korean girlfriend, you know, like you will in like less than 3 months you will be almost a natural.
It's true. I mean, like, honestly, that's probably the best motivation one can get. I'll keep my mouth shut about this topic, but
all right.
It's definitely, if you want to learn a language, get a boy or girlfriend from right. country, for sure.
Whoever works for you. Okay, guys. So and also speaking of the language, well, of course, you know, people love to hear you, you know, and, you know, speak our language and also embrace the cultures. And it's really, really kind that you do that. And also, what's the Myanmar traditional food that you really love?
Honestly, that's a really tough question, because it's like asking me what kind of music do you like. It's, I like so much music, and I like so much Myanmar food that I can't pick my favorite kind of music. Even hip hop is not my favorite music. I can just tell you what I don't like in music, and I tell you what I not really much eat in Myanmar food. Mm. So I'm not that crazy after ngapi, to be honest.
Oh yeah. you don't like ngapi?
Yeah, for me it's too. Maybe it's because
what about you?
It's very spicy. And very ngane, you know?
Ngane, but salty.
Like, salty and very like hnide, you know? Hnide.
Oh, yeah, it's got fishy, like a pungent
fishy
smell.
Pungent, yeah. But for me, it's like, I love shankho soy. For me,
soy
in the morning, some mohinga, some. Even like the Indian Burmese, like the chapati, you know,
chapati,
that's good in the morning, but yeah, like regularly in the I like all kinds of like soups and hing, you know, like the alu hing,
alu, oh yeah,
hing. So, like, I don't eat beef really much, so it's but like the goat and everything.
Yeah. So well, before we play another songs, can you just say you know, one full sentence, you know, like anything just for the record. No, it's all right.
This is the most difficult thing in Burmese, because if you say bae or bae, it's either boyfriend or bean, or you like those kind of things.
Oh, pae or bae. You know,
or like, or whatever, like, or TTT, you know, it's like umbrella, touching, and lottery. So it's like, it's
right.
Really hard for me to make difference.
Yeah, so I'm sure that you were really, really doing really well with that. What about you, Marcel? Are you learning anything?
Yeah, I'm trying to, like, but it's so different, and I haven't been.
You can come for a little bit.
Oh yeah, sorry.
don't be a stranger.
Maybe I'm already, like, it gets harder the older you get. Like, that's the point. When if I would have been like 12, 13, 14, 15, it would have been easier. But right now, it's just like so many.
Mm.
It's so different to our language.
Maybe
it's
you
so
need
hard.
A Burmese girlfriend.
Yeah.
And okay. As Mikis said, you know, I'm really good with numbers, so it's hard for me to learn a language. So
oh, okay.
Point, you know?
So well,
but I will learn, and I'm really willing to learn it.
Is he? It's Mikis teaching you some, you know, Myanmar words.
Oh yeah, yeah. Like, for example, if you say like it's really hot here, for saying you say like bude no.
Oh, bude no.
Or gaung de no. Is this like this? Like this right. Small talk stuff he's teaching me.
Wow, that's awesome. Well, more of that after the next songs. This is Drink I'm Sipping On by Yeji.
Yeji is a Korean song, actually.
Oh, is it?
I love that one.
Right, we're gonna jump to this. Alright, guys, so please enjoy. And we have more talk with Mikis next. Oh, wow.
So, second time Burmese in this.
It's alright. You're doing great. Don't worry.
Third time.
Don't worry.
You should, I think, maybe you should cover your legs.
Are you cold?
No.
Oh! I am feeling this.
It's like, I like the monitors here, like the speakers. Like the standard speakers you have in the record studio.
Yeah, and they, you know, we have really good equipment, you know.
Yeah. I was looking at it, I was like,
this alone can cost like $300-something.
Yeah, yeah.
It's AKG noise. What is it?
So we are using the Neumann. Is that called Neumann? Is it from Germany?
Yeah.
They're like a really
aerodynamic.
Oh yeah, it's German.
Yeah, well,
really good ones.
We're
it's the
using
same
a lot
Mono
of.
Has.
Yeah.
I feel so fine. I feel so fine.
Now, check this.
Hey. Kugelania. I don't know what that means.
I don't know. It means I don't know. It means I don't know. I don't know.
Oh really?
I don't know.
Kugelania, kugelania, ania, kugelania. Oh wow, that's cool. Hey, so let's go to their Facebook. We have a lot of people that joined in to
Zomintat.
Yeah, so Zomintat is like the, he's the, our producer that you met. He's bro Jet to UA. Right, you know, Zimmy Lad, my friend, she say hi, hello.
He's like, hey yo.
But she's supposed to say hello, but you know, it's like, hey yo.
Mingalaba.
Jessica Zin joins. Mingalaba, I called it.
Oh, how about it, really?
You were the line.
Hello. Oh, Miatiri Uda, you know, Tangin Jenny.
Oh, really?
Hey, Miatiri.
Oh, she was there the other night?
No.
Not at the dinner. No. The other friend. Okay, so yeah. Oh, wow. Cool. Alright, so what are your plans after this tonight?
Eat something.
Right.
Eat some
where?
Hen. Eat some hen somewhere.
Hen.
Hen.
Hen. What is
hen?
Know.
Hen
is some curry.
Curry, okay. You know, like a dish.
Lucky 7 maybe.
Oh, no, Lucky 7 is closed.
Shit.
Close. Where are we going? I mean, where? I mean, because I'm gonna be here until maybe I can join after this.
So you're gonna be here till 6, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna be here until 6.
It's some.
Yeah, what was the dish called? Like you don't like?
Meepie.
I know what you mean.
It's not a dish. It's just a sauce.
I know it's a sauce. You introduced me to this when we were in Mandalay. You know, and this guy invited us for this massive lunch.
Oh yeah, I remember. Yeah.
And you invited me. I said, yeah. You
wouldn't
really like it, and I
tasted
it.
It
was like, okay.
Minglawa akoro, tutu minglawa kamya, nunu apini ba akoro. Okay, we are back in 5 seconds. Kuge ania, hey. That's really cool. Thanks for hooking me up with this one. I might be playing that next week, you know. Yeah. So guys, well, we are back at it again with our lovely bro, Mikis and Marcel. Okay, so we're gonna also talk about the fans this time. Right, so fans, well, do you have any like fans encounter? Like, break that day, hello.
Plenty, of course. Like, I mean, positive or negative? Like, usually it's positive, of course, but sometimes, honestly, before I came here, I wasn't that much used to that to
attention.
That whole, yeah, well, like fan situation, because like I was always doing music and it was always fun when I did the show, and at the show, like always felt like I very much appreciated. But after the shows, you know, it was like I came back to a normal life. So now it's like I can't hide anymore. What a lantua lojion, like you know, pono me out, like
oh yeah.
So tira luga jam yare. So like for me, it's sometimes you know throw one day. So actually, I appreciate that the people like
sure
like what I do, but sometimes it's also I would like to hide, you know, like I would like to be not famous, because you you always have to watch what you do, who you're with, or if you whatever, you know. It's not like I do bad things, so it's like I don't have to be afraid that whatever comes out, but for me it's just the fact that it's a very unusual situation for me. And the other day I was walking on the street, and then some girls passed me by, and they were like, ah, come again, and were like, my ears were falling off. It was like a Turkish wedding next to my ears, because like it's so loud, and they were screaming, ah, Mikis. And then they wanted to have some autographs, you know, so I gave them some autographs. And then one girl, she was like shaking, and she just came back from school, and she had her pants, and then they fell on the ground, and she was like, oh my god, I'm so excited to see you. And it's like, excited for what? Like who am I actually? Like, explain to me, like, why are you my, like,
that is awesome.
And it's funny, because like before I released anything in Myanmar, like movies or music or what, I was just being known for speaking Myanmar, which is very strange, because why though? Like in Germany, I expect you to speak German when you want to live in Germany. So when you want to live in Myanmar, I think a foreigner should learn, at least should try to speak Myanmar. And I saw like on Facebook, I saw like a crush list, you know, like my favorite male crush list. And I saw like top 1, top 3, top 2, and I was like top 3, and it didn't say Mikis, it says like Myanmar Lopyota de Nangajara.
So
the white guy who speaks Burmese. And I was like,
wow. So do you have a lot of like you know, of course, obviously you have lots and lots of followers, and do they like DM you, like direct message you? Do you have a lot of DMs? Down in the DMs.
Honestly, like that's top secret. I have two accounts actually.
Oh, a secret one like, and the public one.
But it's like only for family, for example, because they were actually. They were crying about the fact that they can't reach me anymore and I don't answer their messages anymore. And like, this is an open call to everybody, like for my real friends out there. Like, sorry if I don't reply to your messages instantly. It's just like, yeah, it's a bit overload.
Can you say that in Myanmar?
But really, it's like... I had other things even. Apparently there are people that know where I live, so I had stuff like sticking on my wall, like this is a present from me, because like a dream catcher was there.
Whoa.
But it was like I was living on another floor, but it was like on the floor beneath me. And
right,
I was like,
right.
Okay, apparently they know which house I live in, but not the apartment. So
oh,
I was like,
Jesus.
It's kind of scary.
Stalkers.
But, stalker kind of stuff. But I appreciate every person that supports my music and my art. But
Wow. I mean, that's something. Well, I think, you know, from my point of view, I've never reached that point of fame where like people, you know, stalk me to where I live. So that's a relief.
Honestly, that's for me. That's actually a difficult situation, because apparently there are no other like white celebrities. So like all the celebrities in Myanmar are Myanmar. So mm-hmm. or Asian, you know. So
or
I'm
mixed.
Like, or mixed, whatever. But like I'm not Asian. I'm German.
Well, on that note, we might.
Ooh.
Oh. We have another, you know, like celebrity, like who's also happens to make music. We listen to his music on this way.
Yeah.
Didn't we, Martel?
Oh yeah, yeah.
our favorite musician.
Wow, yeah,
we are fans, you know.
Yeah,
like actually,
like
we are big fans of another musician in Myanmar.
Guess the biggest fans. Maybe.
Can we call his name?
Yeah, of course. Shout out.
It's Ujanji. Call out to Ujanji, my role model, my inspiration.
That's what you aspire to be.
If you hear this, Ujanji, like. Call me up, like come to my house, wherever, like let's meet up.
We have a talk.
He's proud and dangerous, but hey.
Well, just leave your guns at home.
I need to smell your aura. I need to be in your
confidence. Like,
wow.
Right. So, great shout out to Ujanji. Whatever you are, and you know, if you're listening to MI Radio, just know that we are a big fan of you too. All right. So, well, we have your song coming up very soon, but you know,
my song or Ujanji's song.
Well, I'm in dilemma. Just kidding. Well, we're gonna be playing your songs, but you know, in between we're gonna play other songs as well. So the next is you know, Boys by Charlie XCX, and also she is, you know, now headlining, not headlining, she is now opening for Taylor Swift Reputation. Okay, so let's talk a little bit. We have like 1 minute, I guess. So let's talk about, you know, Katy Perry and Taylor Swift. Now the feud, like Katy Perry, she like literally sent a literal olive branch. So a few days ago was the opening, the first day of Taylor Swift Reputation Tour. Mm-hmm. So she, you know, she reached out to her. So you know that they have an ongoing like feud for years and years. And Taylor Swift wrote Bad Blood, you know, hey baby, now we got Bad Blood. And then, you know, like Katy Perry wrote back like, swish, swish, and another one in the basket. So they were like back and forth. So, but it was like 2 days ago, Taylor posted on her Instagram that she was like, oh, really thanking, you know, Katy Perry for like literally like sending her an olive branch, and then, you know, with a letter saying like, dear old friend, you know, I've been doing like a lot of rethinking in the past, and you know, like, you know, blah 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 blah, but we couldn't see a lot of it. So what do you think about, you know, that feud? It's like,
to
do we need
frank.
Feud?
To be very frank, like especially two big stars like those two guys, it's like those rapper feuds, you know. It's like, for me, I think it's promotion. I think it's promotion, because they're both big and they promote each other. When I say like your song is bad
here,
and you say your song is bad, then like your fans will listen to your song and
it's a win-win for both.
Yeah, it's a win-win for both, and then in the end they shake hands anyway. So it's like,
right,
it's PR gag, and for me it's like it's a stunt, you know.
Thank God you're here. All right, so well, we have your honest opinions, and now are we gonna play Boys by Charlie XCX, and after at 5 p.m. we're gonna also have the latest local international news. But guys, after this, you know, we have, you know, another, you know, conversation with our brother Mikis again, and we will, you know, be playing his music. So stay tuned, and this is Boys.
Yes,
you know the song, right? All right.
Charlie.
So, which one of are these your songs? No, right?
No.
No, like Higher, like Here.
Yeah, Higher is my song.
I have two Higher. This is not one.
No, none of them.
That's not yours too, right?
No, that's Yellow Claw.
All right, I'm gonna check.
But, when is the when we continue?
Yeah. So we're gonna have
like half an hour.
No, we will end this a quarter plus five.
Yeah.
Five. Sangana is Sangana.
So what about the news? I thought the news are at five.
Yeah, the news will be here at five.
Okay.
Yeah. We can still be here.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Don't worry. We can be here.
But do we have to talk now? Like.
No. After this, we will have the news guy.
Okay. So we can just chill around, and when we continue talking at 15.
I will bring you. I'll bring you. Canali no.
Canali no.
The music and don't talk too much.
The music is great. They seem to know what I like.
They really seem to care about the music. It sounds like they're having a great time.
Music, information, reports. MI Radio. My radio. My way. And on your mobile device, this is MI Radio News.
MI Radio News. I'm Kenneth Seidel. Xi'an State Development Affairs Organization official attended workshop for improved municipal services. A workshop on the 8th and 9th of May was organized by the Asia Foundation and the Renaissance Institute, which brought together 150 municipal officers and chief engineers from all 77 municipalities of Xi'an State to learn from each other and from international experience. the Development Affairs Organization of Galo, Muse, and Sibo make a presentation on the challenges they face in waste management and the reform they have taken to improve landfill management and reduce illegal garbage dumping. A key objective of the workshop was to exchange and learn from each other. Group discussion and scenario exercise on topics such as municipal revenues, mapping garbage roads, and property tax created space for the participant to exchange experience on area for reforms and improvement. The union level joint monitoring committee held its 16th at the National Reconciliation and Peace Center in Yangon, where the outbreak of conflict between nationwide ceasefire agreement signatories were discussed among other issues. JMCU Chairman Lieutenant General Yap Yi said that there were some small outbreaks of conflict between NCA signatories due to weaknesses in meeting and resolving issues among committee members. Both armed organizations are defending and protecting the people according to their own belief, and both need to conduct discussion as soon as possible for displaced persons to settle back in their places of origin and prevent any recurrence of incident between the arms organization. Implementation of decision made in the 15th meeting, discussion made at the secretariat meeting, the summary of JMC second general meeting, the discussion on ceasefire implementation between the 15th and 16th meetings, and general discussion were made at the meeting. In international news, Chinese Premier Li Keqiang said on Thursday that new progress and lasting stable development should be made in China-Japan relationship as it returned to the normal track at the reception marking the 40th anniversary of the treaty in Tokyo. He said it is based on the principles of the four cornerstone political documents that the development of bilateral ties can be led back to the right track in spite of twists and turns in the past. The four documents refer to the 1972 Sino-Japanese Joint Statement, the 1978 China-Japan Treaty of Peace and Friendship, the 1998 China-Japan Joint Declaration, and the 2008 Joint Statement on Advancing Strategic and Mutually Beneficial Relations. U.S. President Donald Trump will meet North Korean leader Kim Jong-un in Singapore on the 12th of June. Donald Trump tweeted that we will both try to make it a very special moment for world peace. In March, Mr. Trump stunned the world by accepting an invitation to meet Mr. Kim for unprecedented sit-down. A pair had previously exchanged insults and threats. The breakthrough came after landmark talks between North and South Korea. Mr. Trump's announcement came after hours after he welcomed home three U.S. detainees released by North Korea. The key issue expected to be discussed is North Korea's nuclear weapon program, over which Mr. Trump and Mr. Kim furiously sparred in 2017. Iraq security personnel on Thursday cast their ballots ahead of Saturday parliamentary election amid tight security. Data from Iraq's Independent High Electoral Commission show that around 940,000 soldiers and police officers are voting at 224 polling centers across the country. According to the head of Baghdad Police Media Office, early voting is open to security personnel so that they can provide security on election day. This will be the first general election since Iraq's victory over the Islamic State in December last year. More news later here on MI Radio.
Okay, guys, so we're gonna have more to talk about with DJ Brussels and also Mikis in the studio. I am so excited, guys. So we're gonna have more conversations later. So stay tuned for all of that. And yes, you're listening to MI Radio.
Hey yo, what's going on everybody? This is DJ Master MIM Show. So today we are going to play Dotani song of Babel Hortex and Electronic Checks, and I hope you will like this feature. So catch our tune from 10 PM to 12 AM. Don't forget it.
After this song, we can have our we can start again. And we'll play your song higher.
Higher and higher and higher.
Higher and then the bass? Is it bass?
Bass.
Right, higher and bass.
Some of their
cousins. Their cousins?
Huh?
Oh, they
some
of
their cousins.
Oh. Can you feel it? Oh, in this? Can you feel it too? You're wearing longji. Longji won't you? Are you? No, that's like a few. What?
When I want to check you,
right? Are you?
I just see this, but this is not you, is it?
That's me.
Is it really you? Because when he checked on, like, you have a photo with Nya, no?
It's a different Russell.
I think that's me. Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Really?
Yeah.
The other I think Russell looks like.
Minglawa, Marcel. Also, the Sobo Tower, he's wearing longji, you know.
Longji. European style, you know.
European style. Yeah, it's very low maintenance. Just wrap it around.
Going live now.
You're going live.
Both going live now.
That is awesome.
Should I go live as well?
Yeah, do that.
Maybe everybody should go live.
It's the first time I went live in a
long time.
Let's wait for a bit. Riffless. Quite bad internet connection here.
Hello, my radio.
Mm-hmm. Mandalay is 96.5.
Yeah.
96.7.
Not only about you know 96.7.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna
rotate that. Can I
rotate the camera? Everybody's live. I'm jealous. Yeah. I want to go live now as well.
Oh, why don't we just you point that to your computer?
I can't turn my phone while I'm live.
Okay, then you know we can just say hi there, and then show it. Marcel, join us.
What?
Nice. What is it like?
This is just MI Radio. Nice. Daniel Serafin. Geil aus Bremen. Bremen Connection. Geil.
It's, you know, so fine. That's about it.
So.
In
Alba. In Alba.
Yeah, I think.
Can you read Nyama now? Moritz setting us.
Okay, so we're gonna talk about that after this. It's gonna be like, dang!
We'll talk it in English, right?
Oh, well, why don't we just do the rest of the interview in Myanmar? You know?
Yeah, so I can understand, right?
So that you feel you don't feel left out. Yeah. I'm Inglawa.
It's Russell's here.
Inglawa, come
here. Marcel's even here, but Marcel. Mm. I'm actually here for Russell, not for Marcel.
Russell and Marcel in the house.
This guy's in.
Russell and Marcel in the house.
Nice.
General Celebi, you might be a dog, my people.
Hello, Kaji.
The general comment, Emma, Mesia Megonishin, Tagalia Balkan. Okay, so 10 minutes, 10 seconds.
Ooh, okay. Go back left.
Marcel?
Everybody's live now.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, I got one view.
All right, you have one view. So now back at it again with DJ Russell's and my awesome bro, Mikis and Marcel. So, well, we just decided that we're going to, just resume our second part of the conversations.
You decided that.
Yeah, I decided that. In Myanmar, 저는 Myanmar로에 벼자매로 성별타바래. 바쁘질로래서 Mikis가 Myanmar로 가까운 벼자대. He can really speak well in Myanmar. So, why don't we just put that to the test? Okay.
조사배면, 다음에 또 쿠쿠 나만의로 시험 콘로바비야. 바로서 저는 어떻게 하든
내내
왜래? 내내 매야다
Oh, it's okay. Then you can okay. English or okay. You can teach me how to speak in Germany, and then I can. Not that I need to teach you, but you know. So okay, let's start with I love you.
고맹어 칠 때.
Ah, Okay. Actually,
I don't want to teach you that in German, because in German it's like it's Myanmarlos. It will be like root word.
Oh, sedlo.
Yeah, sedlo.
Oh, okay.
Well, the ach jamlo like sed is a galong. It's ala jam like the jamlo bada me bian jing.
Oh, okay. Okay. So,
maybe we can find a synonym for it.
It's maybe not the best word, but any other word. Like, you can learn any other word, but I love you is maybe not the good word to learn in German.
Okay.
I won't say it now. It's okay. It's a really rude word in Burmese.
Oh, Myanmarlo jai lo o nene yang ne salo.
Nene yang ne mo da a jai ne. A jai jai ne zagalong so a chi ne zagalong a chi. YouTube mashallah, Google mashallah. Like,
Google mashallah.
Like,
okay.
It's a really rude word.
Okay, jeno shallah man, no? Bilo shin. Bilo shin, a solo shin, Google, mix up about Myanmarlo.
Okay, wa so tron name ko miki wa
okay, well, but my little ma pyo raw no baw lu le so ho do cha stock cost day yau la ma so
yang ko ma be ne de
yang ko
ma be ne be myo ne a ma pyo de
pyo dab bu pyo dab bu okay so aku make it spa ri lou ni le
tron aku music ne patap pi raw a mya yi lou ne a ba so tron aku a chain ne swan ne ti la ho wa le tron akwe thau chin na ja la bi da ma me tron Dio yau gede ya aku tchen lebo track ke tapi me jeno akui thau chan de la so
okay
tapi me tcha project ga a myai shi de so aku di yau shin ga be yai ke de naw pi lo so aku naw de la naw de ga yai daw me so it's like for me jeno ayon su sa lo ma lwe u de la so ba lo so jeno tchen
lou chin
na jeno akui thau chan de so lo akui thau lo shin jeno de cha di tchen au de cha yue chin de ne de cha You know, like 100% simply is on the chain
of
Tejan.
Of course, of course.
Chain and a swan in it. I mean, Kulo Babia, the like, this is like the Nimagonkin, or like, I will read something that's that will be worth waiting for it.
Okay, okay, pretty the Alamanat Honey Jar at Diamond, the Nimagonkin Mara, Alam Sam Yoni Jar at the Chenny de Bogora to Tolay Mel to Biotabar. Okay, so, and also, a chit only me lay out, no? A chit down. Oh, so we have one follower, Katie Kai. So she's calling you a chili.
A chili.
Oh, that's so sweet. That's so sweet. Okay. Okay, a chili. Just get. Is it Katie or. Yeah, Katie Kai. So shout out to Katie Kai.
Shout out to Katie Kai. By the way, everybody who's watching my live video, the connection just broke down. So please switch on to Myanmar International Radio live video. This is a better connection than my own.
Okay, so another you know commenter wrote Nin E L Yoshin Gari Yaipo Shidela Mikis de
Shibare.
Okay, so you've done a lot of movies. Yoshin and Yaji Yaipi Dwabi. Come on. Who are you kidding? So that you know is like I'm not the appetite got it to go out see that people like experience
for me like throw တကယ်ပြောရမယ်ဆိုအာလင်းပြောတာမဟုတ်ဘူးကျွန်တော်မြန်မာနိုင်ငံမှာလည်းရုပ်ရှင်ကအများကြီးမရရတယ်ကိုကျွန်တော် like lead role ကလည်းတကားပဲရခဲ့တယ် only one movie where I played the lead actor this is Mandala Myanmar Band designer ဒီကောက်လည်းပရောထမလို့ကျွန်တော်သေးချင်မပြောတာဟုတ်တယ်ဒီနေ့မကောင်းခင်ဒီနေ့မကောင်းခင်လည်းယုံတင်တော့မယ် so like shit la sell la mine la မထင်းတယ်ဒါပေမဲ့ it's like the Myanmar they have like the censorship and whatever and it takes
some time change you need up
so I mean, you're not going to get it.
Ah, that is and
this is like a really big experience for me because like it's the first movie that I ever like a lead actor.
So exciting. Okay, so So do we know the title?
Mandala Myanmar Bandisa.
Oh, Mandalay Myanmar Bandisa, the Yoshin Kaji
Gopita, the Alume. Yes, so it's like as a lead actor, so this will be before the year finished, there's another movie.
Wow, another movie. So, yes, seems like, you know, you have so many things on your plate, so I'm really happy for you. So, we're going to play another song right now. This is your song, which I love. This is Higher. We're going to get higher with the next track. This is, you know, you produce it.
I produced it, well no, actually Double P produced it, but I wrote the
you
lyrics,
wrote it.
I sung the lyrics, and it's mostly like, it's only one word actually.
Okay, so, well, let's get right to it, and after that we're gonna, you know, have our, you know, last conversation, but it's gonna be really down to the personal. Alright, so stay tuned for that, this is Higher by Mikis.
Yes.
你知道吧 ？OK， so 宅送的千里的风老手表吧的。
宅送的千手路线啊，宅送的千没得千了，宅送的千了我们修路的。
宅送千哦 ，so
宅送的千没阿些的。
阿哥嘞，你妈 Martin Wong， 阿哥你妈千手表吧啦的。Dang, I had no idea. Oh wow. Myanmar ska pyo da le ya myanmar bi yo chit bi yo myanmar yin mu a pye ya twet chu ba no. So this is from Sanor Nyang.
Khmyar.
It's really hard to.
Oh, just over dinner, no.
Stop going live because I got more viewers than if you're not live.
Oh, 15 yeah, we have so many followers. Did you share this post?
Yeah, well, this one.
You did it, right?
I think so. Yes, I just did.
You did?
I just did, yeah.
Oh, that's why we have, like, the viewers got, like, jumped up.
Low connection. Okay.
Right. I would like to know what song are you singing at? Sander Jin? The Chin Sura Chisi Ali.
Aww. This is them.
Aww.
So cute.
Right. Okay, so let's go up. You know, comment it. Oh, okay, so this one.
Oh, can I? Don't know.
You know, I think because of you shared that, we have so many viewers now.
Hey, Russell, you are very nice.
Where?
Ooh, there.
You're very nice. Oh. Motel, I'm a nice person. What do you mean? Who?
She's a motel wave. She looks, I think I know the name. I'm not sure.
Hey, Russell, you're very nice. Oh, yeah, okay.
Thank you. What about me? Come on.
Right, yeah. Don't leave Marcel out. Marcel,
but he's not very nice.
No, not very nice.
He's okay.
Okay.
Just good looking. That's it.
I will try.
So yeah, just make sure to like come forward. You know.
No, it's fine. I'll review the show. I don't want to steal the show. Like it happens all the time. You know, I'm somewhere people are like.
Aren't you the nicest? Well, yeah. Anyway, John Yalima, YKKO John Yalima, Dio Sangara, Boja.
Oh, Polula.
Oh, wow. So you star in the YKKO commercial?
Yeah, like some like YKKO. Jabi,
no?
Jalabi. YKKO, Red Dot, whatever.
Right, so, yeah.
Kobokyo call it. I don't call it Jalabi. Kobokyo, that's not my hound.
Where is that?
Lima.
Kobokyo,
Abo.
Oh, wait, yeah.
Whatever. Kobokyu.
Oh, Kobokyu. I'm not
sure. I'm not sure. Oh,
Kobokyu.
Kobokyu.
Oh, like bo, like in English?
Yeah, bo.
And then Q mean Q?
Yeah, Q. Like, no, Q, like the letter Q.
Oh, right.
What does that mean, sir? My phone does something crazy.
Goji, fighting it. They call you Goji.
But the song's over.
Goji.
Oh, yeah.
Who's Goji?
Goji, they're calling you, that's your account, isn't it?
Sorry.
That's why they're calling you Goji. Goji is like, you know, like in Korea, they call it Oppa, you know? So, Myanmar's got a bit of value, Myanmar, you're chitter, okay. So many comments, so happy. Okay, so we just play another great songs on MI Radio, and I hope you guys enjoy that. And moving on, we have the, you know, we're gonna wrap this up. Anyway, thank you so much for Marcel, thank you. Thank you so much for giving your time, and I hope that you guys have a great time.
We had fun in here. Thank you for inviting us, and
right.
Nice radio channel. Nice idea to have something in English as well. It's very rare. It's the first time in Myanmar that I had to show in
right.
English. It's quite, gives me more confidence to do an interview, honestly.
Right, but anyway, like, well, you're doing well in Myanmar language as well, so I don't think that would make
it. You're doing very, very, very well doing your show in English as well, but
well,
you speak very English than me.
Well,
I
make a living out of it. Just kidding. I gotta make money. Just kidding. Okay, so, well, before we wrap this up, we're gonna, you know, ask you about, you know, the question that everybody in the live comment sessions has been asking. So, Nyamala Wemi Badome, he's actually that coco. He's actually that coco.
Coco, eh?
Coco, yeah.
Honestly, I will I say this. I really hope that she's listening right now, so she won't slap me at home later.
Okay, you're gonna get so a nice spanking.
She has to know that I'm standing to her. So actually, yes, for me it's not that very long, but for me it's I was always taking care about like relationships because I didn't want to give my heart to anybody. You know? Like,
oh yeah.
It's a very difficult thing because love and hate. You know those two things, love and hate. They're very, very big emotions, and I always thought I could never experience that, you know. But like,
right.
I guess I do, and I'm happy in this way, and I hope that the people won't stop supporting me because of that. But I'm still you know, like I'm still the same guy, and I.
Okay.
Yeah, it just makes me.
That's a long answer to a question like, are you in a relationship?
Yes.
Okay, so, alright, okay.
Can you play some thunder sounds like.
Yeah, well, we're gonna look that up later. Like. Okay, so, great. I'm gonna tell you that I'm gonna make this car a good. Chitu, bono, chitu shibare. So, are you planning to, like. Okay, Nimalu. Nimalu, you're like English, you're like. So, like, my tongue is like twisted now.
Mystery of Burma,
We got some.
Oh,
we got some angry reacts.
Ding 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 ding. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Just kidding.
Break your heart. That demo going. But for me, it's like.
Just kidding.
What do I not like?
Sad reacts. Somebody will cry. Mikis got along with chapare, right? You love everybody like your brother and sister.
It's a big heart,
of course. I mean, like for me, it's just a formality.
You know. Okay. So, what's the thing that you like about her? Do it. The chitu bono. You know. The ball jar at Chaka Pabia Pimle.
Do Mikio, Namme Majikin on the ball jar. Do Tira Jalawe.
No,
Adam Yovin. Do not the givers of Dio Yogre or Geno Badu. Do not he's a Matajin, but as he's at Halloween, like, you know, I pay him in a Yama Minklio.
ตะเกอารมณ์เมียมามิงค์ก็คุ้นลบไปแต่ไม่สมมุติว่ามิงค์ก็ตัวยินเนี่ยแหละดิล่ะสุดท้ายก็อ๋อกูมณีก็ไปเอาตองเนี่ยแหละอ๋อเนี่ยไม่ก็ตะปุ่นตวยได้ไอ้คอมมูนิตี้เนี่ยปุ๊ดๆๆๆเลยวอเทเวอร์สเลยซัมติงไลค์แดทสุดท้ายก็อารมณ์หาวนะสุดท้ายนาเลยมูเป้เลยตูเนี่ยตูลงมาเสกก่อนเลยตูเพียตูพ่งหัวเลยเพียเสกชื่อเลยดิล่ะไลค์ตูเพียเสกตูปุ๊ดออกไปล่ะสิเนาะตัวเราปุ๊ดออกไปสุดท้ายตูปุ๊ดออกไปเ Oh, really? Wow, you got a good one. Wow, you got a keeper. Oh, wow. So, wow. I can see that you are in love. So, what about you, Marcel? Are you in a relationship? You know that.
Yeah, kind of.
You can step it up.
Oh yeah, sorry. No, I got a girl back home. She's really beautiful, and right now she's missing me a lot. I miss her quite a lot, but
right.
Still, like, that's tearing me apart because I really love this country. And
Lisa, you're tearing me apart. You have seen that movie?
Oh, no.
I'm going to show you. You don't get that reference, so I will show you that one.
It's just funny how you did it. Tearing me apart.
Yeah, I will show you the video clip later. All right, guys. So Marcel Gado, along le yini de tama mesa bishi mai dagaro Mikis ye da close friend le yini zo tinge chen le phet de lo you like admin le phet par bo no tu ye tu ye lou sha mu ri man nya lo le da naw ka ni de ka like bi manage lo pe ni de da like a personal manager. So yeah, could have you here as well, and I hope that you're enjoying, you know, your stay here. So, is there anything that you want to say, whoever it is, like, listening to MI Radio, or whoever it is, like, watching and, like, commenting our, like, life? MI Radio go na hang ni da break that day go, di jano red life go, chi chu ni da break that day drag go, message li bjo chen na miya ba miya shi le.
Jano, ai da ku ga bjo chen na, like, jano, miki abe da break that go, like,
below Jesuit dinner, General Zagaloni Machu, but also like, Yamazaka, Majora, Arajamaho, like, Zagaloni Machu, so like, there's no word that describes how thankful I am. So now we also the, Yaman Lumioga, the gay through two chari, you know, Gababoma, Nerai.
So you know, like every continent, Jabu. So, you know, Nanga, Mia, Yau, Jabu, Yamalu, Mio, Yamanang, the gate through two chas on, like, Yamanang, Chita, Kalibu, so like, this is really out of the gate, say, Tamanale, but also Ludan, Pure, oh, Germany, Nanga, my day, Germany, my Nanga, Balu, Germany, my Nijin, you know, Akuka, Kamiado, Alon, Pio, Emily, Germany, Nanga, Tamamai, Yamanang, Yamanang, Germany, Nanga, Tapu, Sazabo, Gaunis, so like, really, really know that you are lucky, you're lucky to be a Myanmar, you should be proud.
Yes, you make me feel so proud as a Myanmar citizen. So thank you so much for that. For that, and also thank you for embracing our culture and appreciating it. And also, you know, yeah, it's, so we do appreciate that. And I hope that, you know, we get to see a lot more of you in this 2018. And they are basically asking you, you know, like they want to hear another music very soon. So yeah, make sure to do music, and at the same time you're also a very busy man now, so yeah. And also I wish you the best in your music career, in your personal life, in your love life, you know,
you.
Whatever
we
it is that you
touch
do
anyway.
We're neighbors, y'all.
We just figured that out, so
we're neighbors, y'all. So, and also yeah, I'm gonna wish you the best for Marcel too. Thanks for giving your time here. Jesus Dembare, and just enjoy your stay while you can, you know, and well, just mind the heat outside, but still yeah, just make the most out of it while you're here. Sure. So, all right. So I think that we are so excited, and we felt very, very honored to have you here on our radio shows, and looking forward to, you know, to having you again. You're more than welcome to come back here anytime soon.
Thank you very much.
We're more than happy. You know, like more than half of our people are your fans, you know. I'm not saying that the rest of people are not, but still, you know, they were like hardcore, so they were like really, really excited to have you.
Thank you,
you're more than welcome.
I appreciate it a lot. You're also more than welcome to join my house again, so I will cook for you.
Alu, we're gonna have Alu.
You know, hold a car, do check it, chap it, chat it, let you know, I don't know, aim. And yeah, shout out to Ujonji.
Jonji, yes. Jonji, if you're listening to this, hit us up, you know.
Please.
We
contact
need
me.
Call us.
All right, guys, so and that's a wrap. Well, thank you very much, and we'll have a wonderful Friday evening. And we're gonna play another songs.
So now so much thing like that, you know, Wingwei so that make it produce low tie. So
okay.
So I hope you're gonna like it. It's Rin from Germany. If you have time.
Oh right, of course we have time you know, for a great music. Yeah. So okay. Break the mia alumna not only a solution or Mikis producer tare. With that being said, thank you very much, and have a wonderful Friday evening. Have a wonderful weekend as well, and looking forward to like hearing more of your music. And like, I can guarantee you that we're gonna be playing a lot of your music here on MI Radio. So make sure to tune in every, you know, Monday, Friday, 4 to 6 p.m. All right.
Cheers.
So all right, cheers, everybody.
Thanks, everybody. Love you all.
And just say goodbye to those fans.
Goodbye, everybody, and to the fans, goodbye. to the not fans, like, goodbye
Marcel.
To everybody, love you all, and make sure to tune in every Friday.
Also, okay. Goodbye from my side, because I received 20 new followers, thank you so much for subscribing.
All right.
Keep up following me, right?
Okay. All right, guys, so, all right, yeah. With that being said, we're going to jump right into bass, and then this is also the music produced by Mikis.
Yeah. Boom. Damn.
All right, that's it.
20 new, man.
Nice one.
Thank you,
nice
man.
One. Cheers.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, man.
Thank you.
All right.
So,
Just say goodbye.
Oh, yeah.
Hi.
So everybody, thank you for tuning in. Dima Laji atwa jesum nyai de mare, Api atwa jesum nyai de mare, Russell and Mikio and maybe Marcel. Api atwa jesum nyai de mare. The Myanmar International Radio sa abeba Mikomigo sa abeba, and like Komigo alon chine, and please stay healthy. Chamya gao ma ze, pyo shin ma ze, chana ba ze, atashi ba ze, and everything else. Love you all.
Yay. All right. Thank you very much.